March 24th and 25th, Saturday and Sunday. Wow. You should see the chart. So we have the sun is in Aries and the moon is in Cancer. That's called a square, 90 degrees. Opposite Cancer, we have three planets. We have Mars, Saturn, and Pluto. And up in Aries, we have Mercury, Uranus, and Venus. We've got four in Aries, including the sun, a moon in Cancer, and three in Capricorn. That's called a T-square. Look at it. Very long line, 80 to 180 degrees. Planets are opposite. The third are all these planets up here, 90 degrees to both of them. And then the release of the whole chart, if there was a release point, would be in Libra. So we call this a cardinal T-square. And when there's a T-square in someone's chart, it looks like a lot of red lines. If you go on astro.com and learn how to find the chart, the red lines suggest that someone's come in this lifetime to learn the hard way how to wake up. There's no other way to wake up except the hard way. Some people have a lifetime where it's really easy. They find their sweetheart when they're in high school, and they have these really nice mom and dad, and they had a nice grandma, and then they end up having their job they found, and they get a little dog, and they get a little kid, and then they die. I haven't really met those people yet, but I hear about them, in theory. People are more like this chart. If you could see how many red lines there are, someone comes in with a very difficult lifetime. And what does that suggest for all of you that have had difficult lifetimes? That your soul wanted to wake up, because we only wake up when there's crisis. I don't know who made this up, but we don't wake up under soft circumstances. We wake up when things are very difficult. And then the true hero, a classical Aries, takes difficult situations, all those lemons, and turns them into lemonade. Now that is a high being who comes into this planet and says, give me the hard lesson. I will not complain. I won't be a victim, but I'll keep my heart open. I'll never stop trying, and I'll study astrology. Ah! So if you're studying astrology, it suggests that your soul has a spiritual interest in taking the high road and not being the victim. This chart, at worst, with Aries and Cancer, this is actually what Van Gogh had, it can make a personality type who is really victimized and says things like, I can't get over my story. I can never love again. I can't forgive my parents. I can't forgive my ex-husband. I can't. And if you can't forgive, you won't be able to continue the evolutionary practice of joy. Did I tell you that I'm the president of the Jews for Joy Club? And I don't have very many members because they always go, oy, there's so many people, not just Jews, but so many people on the planet that find pain as their landing pad. This chart could go one of two ways. Saturn and Capricorn, they could learn their hard lessons. They can use their Cancer and open up their heart and care for people. And they can use all that Aries energy to get up. Or they could have a lot of physical problems and feel really under the weather and feel very victimized. See what I mean? It's a decision. And right now, starting today, on March 24th and 25th this weekend, you can make the decision that you're going to take the high road and take the difficulty of your life and lift it up into a beautiful story. If you need some help, I have a book called The Missing Element. And in that book, I speak specifically to crisis and how hard it is in life when things are painful to turn them into lemonade. So we're serving lemonade, Astrology Answers and Deborah Silverman, March 24th and 25th, a lot of lemonade.